Let's look at Gemini Nano, our most efficient model for on-device tasks. It runs directly on mobile, enabling low latency responses and data privacy.
While generative AI is transforming the mobile capabilities from refining essays to creating imagery, developers face the fundamental challenge of achieving the speed and privacy of on-device AI without sacrificing the power and flexibility of cloud-based models. In Android, we have something brand new that will help developers bring this next generation of mobile AI to life. Intrigued, I naturally reached out to Oli, a product manager on the MLKit team, to hear all about this new capability.
So we're officially announcing the MLKit's GenAI prompt API. It unlocks powerful on-device AI capabilities with Gemini Nano, our state-of-the-art model. We know developers need power and performance now, and that's why we're thrilled to share how partners like Kakao Mobility are already building powerful, fast, and private on-device intelligence solutions today. And thanks to MLKit's prompt API, you can too. This API supports both text and image understanding. So if you want to create tags or descriptions of images, or perhaps manipulate complex data into short, punchy headlines or detailed in-app breakdowns, it's all possible with this model.
Next, I wanted to understand from Oli what the key benefits are from having this processing done on-device.
On-device processing really shines for several key use cases. So first, the data stays totally on-device. Everything is local, and that means it's perfect for sensitive information or low latency needs. There's also excellent cost efficiency. Since all inferences remain local, there's no additional cloud costs. Finally, there's simplified management. With the API using AI Core to handle the complex work of distributing and updating Gemini Nano and utilizing specialized hardware like MPUs for the best performance. We're looking forward to enabling developers to build a wide range of new experiences and can't wait to see what you build.
The technical benefits of Prompt API are persuasive, but I wanted to know more about what new opportunities it unlocks. So I connected with a team who has already started building with it. I chatted with Jim Wu, an Android developer, and Harim, a product manager from Kakao Mobility. They're leveraging the Prompt API to deliver a better user experience, improving their key business metrics.
Kakao Mobility is one of Korea's leading mobility platform developers. We've grown the Kakao T app into a multi-dimensional app offering everything from taxi hailing and navigation and bike and scooter sharing and parcel delivery with over 30 million active users.
Kakao Mobility's first live feature used the Prompt API to automate their parcel delivery service. They leveraged the API to efficiently extract vital information like recipient addresses and phone numbers from complex, unstructured user input, all on device.
Before these features, users had to manually fill names, addresses, and phone numbers into the order form. A slow process. Using Prompt API with Gemini Nano, we introduced the auto-entity extraction feature. It automatically recognizes necessary information from natural language. So then user can request a delivery with chat messages. It converts elements like the address and the phone number into a clean JSON format.
Wow. Then what about for your second feature, bike parking violation detection, which addresses safety and reckless parking? This is a crucial use case as it involves multimodal input. So how does on-device AI fit into this?
Public perception of personal mobility devices has suffered due to issues like reckless parking and safety concerns. We want to address this by analyzing photos users take after parking and providing real-time guidance. This task is only possible by leveraging the Prompt API's multimodal power.
With results like a 45% increase in new user conversion, the on-device AI revolution is clearly just getting started. For more detailed documentation on all of the GenAI APIs, be sure to check out the official documentation page and sample on GitHub.